now take leaders' questions under Standing Order 29, Deputy Micheál Martin.
Just very quickly, Cian Chola starts today by acknowledging the hurt and absolute devastation being experienced by the Creagall and Valdez families over the last number of days. Our thoughts and prayers are with them. Both Anna Creagall and Yasin Valdez were taken violently and brutally, and their families and communities have been left broken-hearted. And we pay tribute to the Gardaí and the first responders for all they're doing in such very devastating and traumatic situations. Taoiseach, in 2014, Louise O'Keefe won a major breakthrough case in the European Court of Human Rights in relation to the state's culpability in child sexual abuse in our primary schools. And the government's response to that judgment has been a significant failure, and I would argue represents the very worst of an adversarial approach to victims of child sexual abuse in our schools. These were abused by teachers who have subsequently been convicted. It is a scandal in itself, the response to the European Court's decision, and it needs to stop, Taoiseach. And I ask you the question, why is the government fighting survivors of sexual abuse tooth and nail? The redress scheme and the conditions attached to it represent a deliberate and quite shocking interpretation of the O'Keefe judgment. By imposing a condition of prior complaint on the availability of redress, the government has shifted the onus from itself to take proactive and preventive measures to vulnerable children who are victims of sexual abuse, in other words, to make disclosures leading to complaints. We know that multiple international research studies show that the vast majority of children who are victims of sexual abuse do not disclose that abuse. Those that do wait a significant period of time before doing so. Therefore, prior complaints are incredibly unlikely to exist. And indeed, even though there are 360 known victims of sexual abuse in national schools, a prior complaint has only been established in respect of a single abuser to date. As Conor O'Mahony at the Child Law Clinic at University College Cork said, and I quote, "The condition of prior complaint is not designed to limit the scope of liability. It is designed to eliminate it." Just 7 offers, Taoiseach, of settlements have been made under the scheme, all of which relate to prior complaints in respect of one single abuser, even though at least 360 cases arise for consideration. A settlement rate of just 2% is not indicative of a humane, flexible or holistic approach. Are we really suggesting, Taoiseach, that the victims here will have to go back again to the European Court of Human Rights to get justice in terms of the government's interpretation of the original O'Keefe decision, or a second application will have to be made to the court? I've met the victims concerned. The government is putting them through huge trauma right now by the approach it has adopted. And I would ask you, Taoiseach, to change direction and stop the approach you are taking and go back and give justice to those who are victims of such terrible abuse.
Just at the outset, I'd like to join with Deputy Martin in condemning the senseless and brutal crimes that we've seen in the last few days, which we condemn unreservedly. Although nothing we can say will bring back Anna Creagall or Justine Valdez, I hope we can provide some reassurance to the many young women and families out there who are scared and concerned. I want to particularly recognise the Garda Síochána for their very swift action in dealing with these two terrible crimes. I want to thank the Defence Forces and the Civil Defence as well for their assistance that they gave the civil authorities. There is a GSOC investigation underway for reasons that people will understand. Also, the Department of Justice is contacting the families with the view to assisting them. The Taoiseach has made contact with the Filipino embassy to see if there's any assistance that we can provide, and also in relation to Anna Creagall, the National Education Psychology Service has sent a team into Anna Creagall School to assist the children there, for whom it must be a very difficult and very shocking time, and this was discussed at Cabinet this morning. In relation to the Louise O'Keefe case, I can absolutely assure you that the government fully accepts the judgment of the European Court and is now implementing that decision, and we will deal with it as sensitively as we possibly can. Our interpretation of the judgment is that in order for us to be in a position to pay compensation, to pay redress, there must have been a prior complaint. And as you know, as has been the case with so many other redress schemes, whether it's the symphysiotomy redress scheme, which I was involved in putting together, or whether it was a scheme, for example, like the scheme we put in place for women who were residents in the Magdalen laundries, it's necessary in all cases that there be evidence, and it's based on evidence that that redress is made, and that's the basis on which it's the, we're operating into the future. But certainly, I know Minister Bruton is very engaged in this issue, is very much on top of it, and has met people affected and people concerned, and I know he will deal with it in as sensitive a manner as he possibly can.
In the most sensitive manner possible. You are dealing with this in the most insensitive manner possible. The prior complaint is a device to circumvent your responsibilities. There's only one case in Dundera in relation to the prior complaint in relation to an abuser. Most children in primary school don't disclose until years later that they've been abused. Are we seriously suggesting that the prior complaint is legitimate? That a child who's been abused, where the rapist has been convicted and the paedophile convicted and is in court, or sorry, is in jail as a result of his conviction, where there's absolutely no doubt that the most appalling abuse was visited upon a person. We have now forced that person through high courts, Supreme Courts, European Court, and this government is still saying you are entitled to no redress, you are entitled to nothing. Because of a legal device that has been implemented to eliminate liability and not admit it. It is a shocking scandal in itself, Taoiseach. And in the last weeks, we've been talking about trying to end this adversarial approach. I have not come across anything as bad as this. And the trauma, believe me, Taoiseach, of the victims is intense. Intense, Taoiseach.
Your time is up.
And that's the only reason I'm bringing it up here again on the floor of the House. You've got to change direction on this. It is inhumane what you are doing to the victims who are trying to seek legitimate redress as a result of being abused in primary schools. The European Court has ruled it's time we took up our responsibilities as a state and you as a government do the right thing by them.
Taoiseach.
Again with the Minister for Education, and as I said, he's very much aware of the issue. We're very much of the view that we are complying with the UN, or rather with the European Court judgment on the matter. If it is the case, as you say, that abuse has occurred and there is no doubt about that, well then that is something obviously we're going to have to consider. But I think people will understand when it comes to any scheme of compensation or any redress scheme, there does need to be some evidence that the claims being made or alleged abuse took place. And that was very much the case in previous redress schemes that have existed in the past. But if, as you say, there is no doubt that abuse has taken place in these cases, certainly I think that is something that we can examine, and I will take it up with the Minister of Education soon.
Thank you very much, Taoiseach. Before proceeding with business, I wish on my own behalf and behalf of members of the Dáil to offer Cead Míle Fáilte a most sincere welcome to a delegation from the Conference of Presidents of the Committees of the Regions led by Mr. Carl Heinz Lamberts. The delegation is here to engage with the EU Affairs Committee and other stakeholders, and I wish them every success on their short visit.